Random scan display. So that is a drawback in the raster scan display. What is the drawback means? It can draw only the straight lines. The raster scan display can draw only the straight lines. Whereas in random scan display, it's not like that. You can even also draw the curved lines. For example, you can say like this. If you want to draw a curved lines, you can use what? You can use random scan display. But whereas in raster scan display, we cannot draw a curved lines. So here also, in random scan display, if the picture is like this, means the electron beam which is generated from the electron gun will fall on the position of the image itself. Only on the exact position of the image, the light will be placed. Then we will be getting the picture fully. That is the advantage of this random scan display. Whereas it is not like that in the random scan display, the raster scan display. Because in the raster scan display, the light of the beam, the light from the beam will be traversing row by row, each row by row it will be traversing, but here it is not like that. Exactly on the picture, the light will be appear. That is the random scan display. It is the main advantage. Next, we are going to see the color CRT monitors. In this color CRT monitors, the light which is generated from the light which is obtained from the electron beam will be creating different colors on the pictures. So this color CRT monitors can be used by using two types of methods. One is beam penetration method. Another one is shadow mask system. In this beam penetration methods, the CRT monitor consists of only two colors. One is red, another one is green. So, in this CRT monitor, as I told you, the screen actually, you know. In this beam penetration method, the CRT monitor consists of two phosphorus screens. One screen is for red, another screen is for green. So, it depends upon the combination of the colors. Either this electron beam falls on the red, the screen will appear red. If it is falling on the green phosphorus screen, it will produce a green color display. Or the combination of both the red and green forms orange and yellow color. So totally this beam penetration method can produce only two colors, orange and yellow, apart from this red and green. This is what we call it as what? Beam penetration method. The next one is the shadow mask method. In this shadow mask method, we have three electron guns produces three electron beams. Why we are using three electron gun means, for each and every color we are using one electron gun. One is for red, one is for green, and one is for blue. So when it falls on the screen, if red color is emitting on the screen will be displayed in red. If green color is electron beam is emitted on the screen, then green will be displayed. If blue will be displayed. As we are having three colors, so the combination of any two or any three will be producing more colors. That is the main advantage of this. or disgrace.
So now we are going to see the next topic,
direct view storage tubes. So in this direct view storage tubes, the picture definition is directly stored as the charges. In normal CRTs, each and every time the picture definition has to appear on the screen. It has to traverse through the picture definition, and from picture definition it has to go through the buffer memory, or you can say it as frame buffer, and then on the first process. This happens in the normal CRT. Whereas in this direct view storage tube, it directly, the picture definition is directly goes through the buffer memory and to the phosphorus coating. That is the difference. In normal CRT, it has to, the picture definition has to go through the buffer memory, and from buffer memory it has to go to the phosphorus. But in direct view, the picture definition will be directly stored inside the buffer memory itself. So from buffer memory, directly the image will be displayed on the phosphorus. What is the advantage of this thing means? The picture resolution will be very, very high. Using this direct view storage tube, the picture resolution will be very high. And what is the disadvantage means? If you want to remove, this is the picture. If you want to remove any part of the picture, for example, I'm saying that if you want to erase this part, you can't erase this part alone. If you want to erase it, you have to erase the whole picture. You cannot make any updates. That is the drawback in this direct view storage. If you want to remove this part, means you have to remove the whole picture. That is the main disadvantage in this.